Hi, I'm Dr. Stan Kuchar at teenmentalhealth.org, and today I want to talk with you about a very emotionally difficult subject, and that is the prevention of youth suicide. We know that the death of any one young person by suicide is a tragic event. Its effects go through the family, the community, the friends, the schools, and wider. And it's really, really important that we do the best job that we can to try and prevent death of any young person by suicide. But it's equally important that when we do that we make sure that the things that we do are things which are likely to have an impact on decreasing death by suicide. In fact, I would say that if we're doing things in youth suicide prevention that don't decrease death by suicide, we're doing the wrong thing. Reality-wise, there are a lot of things that we do that make us feel good. There are many things that we try to do because we want to do the right thing. But you know, wanting to do the right thing and doing the right thing are sometimes very different. We like to get communities involved. We like to get people talking about it. That might be the way to go. But we need to do more than that. We need to actually put into place programs, interventions that we know are much more likely to have the good evidence behind them that they decrease death by suicide. And we need to avoid doing things that either don't or that we don't know if they do. Frenetic activity is no substitute for understanding and effective outcomes. Walking around a school and having a convention or conference and auditorium on about suicide, that doesn't prevent suicide. So what does? Well, there are a couple of things that we know are likely to help. Gatekeeper programs, teaching trusted adults how to identify young people who may be suffering from a mental disorder and then getting them into the care that they need. Improving the diagnostic and treatment competencies of health providers, primarily in primary care, and also helping them understand how to manage suicide risk better. Those things, they can be helpful. But you know, there are a lot of programs that are sold at quite a substantive profit to their purveyors, which are very popular, but have not been shown to prevent suicide. These programs are very popular in communities, they're popular in schools, but the evidence that they actually prevent any death by suicide just isn't there. And there's a problem in using those programs. Not only are we unlikely to get the desired outcome, but when we're using those programs, we think we're doing something right, and we stop thinking about what are the right things to do, and very often we then don't invest into putting into place those things which are much more likely to work. So if you're thinking of investing in a suicide prevention intervention, that's a great thing to think about. But I'm going to ask you to do one thing before you actually make that step. Ask one question. What is the evidence that the program, that the intervention that you want to put into place has actually decreased death by suicide in young people? And if you don't have the evidence, then I would suggest you start looking for things that do have the evidence. Don't take the word of the person that's selling you the program. They have an interest. They're selling the program. Our mutual responsibility is to try to put into place those things that are most likely to work and avoid those things that are likely not to work. Thanks for your attention and for your interest in this very important topic.